we want to determine the domain and range of a function given the graph of the function. The domain is a set of all possible x values of the function. X values occur along the x-axis or the horizontal axis, and the range is a set of all possible y values of the function, and y values occur along the vertical axis. So if we're given the graph of a function and we want to determine the domain of the function, we want to project the graph onto the x-axis or determine how the graph behaves horizontally along the x-axis. What I mean by that is notice how the leftmost point of this graph occurs right here when x is approaching -3, and the rightmost point on the graph would be here when x is equal to +2. And the graph would also contain every x value between -3 and 2. But there's one more thing we need to be careful about here. -3 is not going to be in the domain of this function because of this open point here. So let's make an open point here to indicate that. But notice that x equals 2, this point is closed, so it would include +2. So the domain of this function is going to be from -3 to +2, not including -3, but including +2. So if we want to express this using inequalities, we would say x is greater than -3 and less than or equal to +2. If we want to use interval notation, the interval is from -3 to 2. It includes 2, so it's closed on 2, so we use this square bracket. And it's open on -3 because it does not include -3, so we use a rounded parenthesis. These two mean the same thing. And then to determine the range, we now want to project this function onto the y-axis or determine how it behaves vertically. So again, notice how the lowest point on this graph here is approaching -5, and then it includes every y-value all the way up to this high point when y is +5. But notice how it's not going to include -5 because of this open point, but it will include +5 because of this closed point. So the range is going to be from -5 to +5, not including -5 and including 5. So we can say y is greater than -5 and less than or equal to +5. We're using interval notation, square bracket for 5 because it includes 5, and a rounded parenthesis for -5 because it does not include -5. Now let's go and take a look at a second example. We'll start by determining the domain. So we're going to project this function onto the x-axis or determine how it behaves horizontally. Well, the leftmost point occurs right here at x equals -4. And then notice how the graph moves to the right indefinitely because we are assuming this graph is going to continue in this direction. So the domain would start at -4 and then move to the right indefinitely, meaning it's going to approach positive infinity. So the domain would be x is greater than or equal to -4. Or using interval notation, we have the interval from -4 to infinity. It includes -4, so we have a bracket. And then for infinity, we always use a rounded parenthesis. And then for the range, we want to project this function onto the y-axis or determine how it behaves vertically. So the lowest point on this graph is right here at y equals -4. This is a closed point, so it does include -4. Now when we try to determine how high this graph goes, we need to be careful because of course it is moving to the right very fast, but notice how it also is moving upward. So even though it's not shown on the screen, this graph would continue to move upward, and therefore the range is going to approach positive infinity. So the range would be y is greater than or equal to -4, or using interval notation, just like for the domain, it'd be closed on -4 to positive infinity. Okay, so I hope these two examples were helpful.